We saw, I think, two sort of mirroring phenomena in the early 90s. One, again, was the Democrats moving in the direction of the Republicans on welfare reform, and the other one was them moving more towards deregulation and towards the financial services industry on those questions. So they were trying to court more campaign finance money from the financial services sector, from the business sector. They, from a policy perspective, moved more towards deregulation than they had before. And so they relied less on the old coalitions of, you know, minority coalitions. They relied less on unions, and they relied more on money from Wall Street and from big business. And this resulted in a kind of political consensus on both of these questions, both policing towards the people without money and on the flip side, deregulation. What began as deregulation in the white-collar sector, and what I think is ended as a kind of non-enforcement on certain questions in the white-collar sector. I think neither party has really been an effective lobby for reform on that question, dating back quite a while now.